Hey everyone, it's Rahul here from Tech Review Pro, and in today's video you will learn how to prepare your iPhone for iOS 26 update the right way. Watching this video is very important so that you may avoid any big errors like the green screen of death or the white screen of death error while updating. So without any further delay, let's get started. The first thing you need to consider before updating your iPhone to iOS 26 is check whether your iPhone is supported for iOS 26 update or not. As you can see here, these are the iPhones that are supported for iOS 26 update. That means iOS 26 is only compatible on these iPhones, and if you have an iPhone that isn't on the supported iPhones list, you won't be able to install iOS 26 on that iPhone. Alright, once you are sure that your iPhone is supported for iOS 26, the next thing you should do is check storage space on your iPhone, as the iOS 26 update comes with at least 7 to 8 GB of update, and depending upon the iPhone you have, the update size may vary. So if your iPhone is low on space, the iOS 26 update might not even download and install. So you need to free up your iPhone space to at least 10 GB so that the iOS 26 update can be installed on your iPhone without any problem. If your device is running out of space or your iPhone's data storage space is full, you can erase all the unnecessary files, photos, videos, etc. to free up space on your device. You should also delete and remove any such apps that you had installed previously but you are no longer using or haven't used recently. If you want to check out your iPhone storage, simply go to Settings and after that tap on General, and this will take you to the general settings on your iPhone. From here, select the iPhone storage. After that, it will show you all the details about the apps and the files that are consuming your iPhone data and storage space, including how much of your iPhone data storage is being consumed by each of them. Apart from that, you can also enable settings for offloading unused apps. That will help you release your iPhone space for the iOS 26 update. Simply go to settings and then scroll all the way to the end. There you will find apps. Tap on that and then tap on App Store. Here scroll a bit and you will see there is option for offloading unused apps, and this feature named offload unused apps simply uninstalls those applications from your iPhone that you have not been using for quite some time recently. And don't worry, all your data still remains saved, so whenever you need it, you may always tap on install button or the app itself, and the app will start installing again without losing your data. Thus, offloading unused apps on your iPhone will free up the space on your iPhone so that you may smoothly download and install iOS 26 update on your iPhone. The next thing you need to consider before updating your iPhone to iOS 26 is ensuring that you have charged your iPhone properly. Even if it's not fully charged, make sure you have charged it to at least 80%, because while updating iOS 26, it will need more battery power to install updates, and hence it may consume the battery power of your device quickly. If your iPhone is not charged, your device battery may die soon and the update might get stuck in the process. Why? It's because during the iOS 26 update process, your iPhone will shut down and restart multiple times. So if your iPhone is not sufficiently charged, the process will stop in the middle, and that might cause data loss on your iPhone. If the update gets stuck in the middle, you will need to restore your iPhone using the iTunes or Finder app, and this will erase all the data of your iPhone. Therefore, make sure that you have sufficiently charged your iPhone before updating to iOS 26, because it's mandatory to have enough battery juice to keep the update process running until it's completed. And by the way, make sure you don't plug your iPhone to charger while updating, because during the update, your iPhone heats up a lot, and updating your iPhone while being plugged into charger will further be increasing the temperature of your iPhone. As a result, this may cause your iPhone's screen becoming faulty or facing green screen of death or white screen of death issues. The same happened with various users previously when they tried updating iPhone 13 and iPhone 14 series iPhones while being plugged into power outlet. So better be safe than sorry. And the fourth and the most important thing you can do before updating to iOS 26 or any other iOS versions is to back up your iPhone. This is necessary because when you update your iPhone, Maybe something doesn't work properly or anything may create some problems after updating to the new iOS version. Usually this doesn't happen quite often, but if it does, in that case, you might want to roll back to the previous version of iOS to get back the iOS 26 on your iPhone. Therefore, having a backup of all your data will be a lifesaver for you. So make sure you backup your iPhone by going to settings and after that, tap on the Apple account or Apple ID option and from here select iCloud. Now tap on iCloud backup and enable this option to backup your iPhone. If you don't have sufficient iCloud storage to backup your iPhone, you may go to iPhone settings and after that select and tap on general. Now from here scroll down and select the option that says transfer or reset iPhone. After that you will see this option that says prepare for new iPhone. Simply tap on get started. In case you don't know, this is a free method to achieve unlimited iCloud data storage so that you can backup all of your files. You may backup all your data no matter the size and keep that unlimited data in this iCloud storage for 21 days for free. And by the way, after 21 days, that data stored in the unlimited free iCloud data center will be deleted. But that shouldn't be an issue as you already have at least 21 days to recover all of your data. Just in case, if you are facing any problem and you want to roll back to the previous version. If backing up to iCloud is not something you prefer, maybe because of cellular data charges, then you have also got the option to backup your iPhone by using iTunes on PC or Finder on Mac. If you don't have any idea how to backup it on a PC or Mac, then I have created a video. So make sure you tap here to watch that video.